Hello, this is Blake Cannon, woodworker, and today we're going to be making a hovercraft. At least I'm going to try. I think it'll work. Hopefully it does, because it takes quite a bit of supplies, and I don't want to waste them. So first I have a piece of half-inch particle board plywood that I got recently. It is cut in half, and I used my circle gauge that I made last week, which it is, where did I put it? Well, anyways, oh, here it is. The circle gauge that I made last week, and I have it fully extended, and I put it in the center and traced out my circle. I'm cutting it out with a jigsaw. And every so often when you cut it off, like right here, I cut that in, and this is all hanging down. It's got a lot of weight on it, and I don't want it to break, so I can still use some of that. So you just chop it off. So I'll cut around maybe halfway, chop it, or maybe all the way. And I just have it sitting in the saw horses. But I'm just going to cut this out with the jigsaw. And about the circle gauge video, I don't know why I only uploaded about half of it. I'm going to try uploading the rest of it. I don't know why I did that. I don't know if it was too long, but I've had like 17-minute videos before, and they've uploaded just fine. So I don't know what was wrong with that one. But, so, here we go. Okay, so I have my circle cut out. It's going to be big enough for me to sit on, and I have to hold the back. I think I'm going to use my shop vac. My shop vac, where is it? Over here. I will drill it, or cut about 2¼-inch hole, I think is what it is. It's a 2-inch shop vac, but if after you measure after the thickness of the plastic, it's about 2¼, I think. So I'll drill a hole about like right here. And then I'll just take the vacuum out of the main canister, the vacuum, just the power part with the filter and the motor on it. I'll just sit on it and hold that. So now I'm just going to take my random orbital sander, sand around the edges, sand on the top a little bit because I don't want to cut the plastic, or if you run into something or somebody, it would probably hurt them. So I'm going to go ahead and sand around the edges. Okay, I am using a 60 grit. Sanding pad, because it'll make the process a little faster, And I'm probably going to be taking away quite a bit on the edges. And a higher grit will take longer to sand. So I'm just going to sand around the edges and on the top and bottom. The clear shower curtain that goes on the inside of the tub, like you have your tub, and then you have the outside shower curtain and the inside one. This is the inside one. It is a 2.4 gauge, which I don't know exactly what that means on the thickness, but it will work for me. So I don't think I'm going to be using all of it because I'm definitely not going to be using all of it because it's quite big. Quite large. Actually, it's really huge. But this should be thick enough plastic. Or you can use paint. They make paint drop cloths, or just drop cloths that are used, like you drop them down whenever you're like painting or something. You don't want to get the floor dirty, or you have paint on it. I'll also use one of those. I'm gonna lay this. Actually, I'm gonna do this on the ground. It'll be easier to do on the ground because you want this to be flat to the bottom. So I'll just lay this out on the ground. You lay your piece of wood right in the center. Then you'll fold around the edges of it. So, like I said, the rough side I want to be under the bag, so it's smoother when you're sitting on it. So you'll lay it down like that, and now you'll take staples and some more pieces of wood I'm going to cut to go like maybe around the edges to give it some more seal. I'm gonna put some wood glue down with it too. That'll just like create a little seal because I don't have like silicone or anything. But the wood glue will act as a seal. So I'm gonna go ahead and get everything ready and I'll be back. Okay, I am using 3/8 inch staples in my staple gun. And if you watch my tip of the week video, one of them says not to leave your glue in the cold because it will freeze, and then when it thaws out, it won't work as good and won't be as strong. So I'm going to go ahead and use that. Like I said, I'll use it in projects that don't have to be as strong or something that is just being used and doesn't matter about. So I'm just going to be using this glue that was frozen. Well, maybe I'm not because I just pulled the whole cap off. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to be using this glue. There we go. Okay. So I'm just going to put glue around the edges and fold this all up. You don't want it to be super tight against it, but not really loose either. And you're totally not going to be folding this all up. You'll only go in about an inch or so over here, and you'll staple it all in. You won't bring this all the way in like this and staple it in here. You're just going to staple it right in there. So I'll go ahead and put some my glue down. Just a little bit at a time. This bottle doesn't want to break it. Let's just pull this off like I already did. Just do it like this. That's quite a bit of glue. Okay. See, it's kind of chunky too. So it really isn't that good. So I'm going to be... So you fold this up. Kind of loose, not super loose. Just fold this up around here like this. Like, don't pull it like as tight as you can. Just make it a little snug around. Go ahead and staple this all down. Staples. Wasn't really in there. You're gonna need probably quite a few staples for this because you have to staple all the way around. Locked up. Okay, so I got that pretty good round. I'm going to grab my knife if I can find it. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut around this. About an inch and maybe half inch. And move your fingers like I did not. Gosh dang. And since I took that cap off, the glue comes out very quickly, and I was not expecting it. So there is quite a bit of glue on here, which is okay. So I'm going to cut him. I tried making another hovercraft before this one. It didn't quite work out. I didn't try my best. Because I didn't think it was going to work. But it got pretty close to working. Then I cut the holes in the bottom of it. And I cut them too big, so then it did not work after that. Okay, so now that we have that all stapled on, there's glue everywhere. If you look at the back of it, I have a plastic in here which will fill up with air and hopefully make you hover. And I should have drilled the hole first, because now I'm going to drill a hole in plastic. Crap. I think it'll be okay. Okay, so I'm going to get set up for cutting that hole, and I'll be back. So now I have a 2.5-inch hole, which will be good enough. I can just wrap duct tape around the hose, because the last one I had to chisel out some and everything. I can pick this. So now I'm going to try, like, getting this to the middle, which is it's quite tight, because I'm going to really wish I would have drilled that hole first. Can't grab this enough and pull it away. Here. Hole's going to be at this side right here. I still think I'm going to end up cutting it. I really don't want this to be cut. No, that won't work. There's the bit right there. I don't really want it to cut through here. I don't know how to there's no way I can protect it. Hold on your drill good, because you're only using one hand, it can spin around, so that's why I'm just tapping it. I need to get a grip on this. There. Yes, I did it. I'm so glad. So see, you can get things to work if you just take your time. Wow, I did not think that was going to work. Man, I am so glad that worked. Okay, So now on the back, you get to make holes in it. Just didn't need a hole there. Okay, so I'm gonna set up that first. Okay, so now we're going to move that out of the way. And go ahead. Oh. Okay, go ahead. Move this out of the way for now. Okay, that piece of wood. So let's sit here. Bring in our saw horses. Okay, so we're going to take the circle maker or circle jig and we're going to set this so I can cut a hole. I don't want it to be super big. This is actually as small as I can get it. That's too big. Going to find a lid or something circle because I don't have a. Oh, you can use like a coffee can lid, but I don't have one of those. So I'm just, you cut out a piece of wood. It's like a giant washer, pretty much. But I don't know what I can use to trace. Here we go. I think this will work. Yep, perfect. Grab a pencil. Okay. Trace right on the edge. Doesn't have to be perfect, but somewhere near a circle. Okay, so now I'm gonna cut that out with the jigsaw. And put the jigsaw back in. Okay, so go ahead and cut. So now I'm going to go ahead and use the sander. Wait, I need to cut this a little bit more. Right here. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead. Okay, go ahead and sand this with it. Orbital sander the edges again. Which is right there because it's at least it's pretty close. Doesn't have to be exactly, but there is, if you can make it exact, then make it exact. So I'm gonna grab a screw, I think. Just an inch screw will work. I'll put three in. Really, you can only put, or you inch screws. So that will go dead in the center around that. You know, that might be a little bit big. No, I think it's good. Okay. So just about in the center. Watching this whole video before you build one, just in case it doesn't work out as great as you think. Then I can tell you what to do differently if I know. Hopefully it works. It really seems to be cool. I don't know. That's okay. So now you have that. We need to cut six holes. One, two, three, four, five, six, like that. I think I'm gonna experiment. I'm gonna cut four first. One, two, three, four. I'm gonna cut four first. They don't have to be exactly circles, they can be triangles, whatever shape. Just about an inch, inch and a half wide. I'm just gonna cut a triangle. Kind of hard to see the plastic on the pipe. Two. Three. Okay, now we can flip it back over. Now we should be able to hook up our vacuum. And hopefully this will work. I'm gonna test it. See, that's big, so I'm gonna take duct tape. Where did I put it? Right here. And you can put cardboard around it too or whatever, but I'm just gonna put a lot of duct tape around this hose. So that way it will fit into here. So go ahead and put duct tape on your shop vac hose. Doesn't have to be perfect. And remember, you don't want to put it on the suction. You want to put it on the where it blows the air out. And if your vacuum doesn't have one of those that you can plug into, then your vacuum will not work for this. You'll have to get a leaf blower or something. So I think that's good. Because I need quite a bit of duct tape for mine. And that's very ethical tape. Squeeze it tighter. I think it's really not too much tape. Let's take off some. Go ahead and rip it there. That is way better. Okay. Now, plug in the vacuum, see mine blows out here.
Set in the camera.
Sucks in here, blows out here, so hook it up where it blows out. Now I'll plug this in. Can you tell I'm getting anxious? Anxious? No, anxious? Yeah, anxious. I think that's it. How about I just say, can you tell I'm getting excited? A little bit easier to say. Okay. So, I'm gonna turn it on and see what happens. I think it might work. I really, really hope it works. Oh, jeez. I'm going to take this filter off because it is super dirty. I hooked it up to the planer today, and it's filled. And the filter needs to be changed. I really want this to work so badly. So it's like a try. It's quite a bit of wood. Okay, so I'm going to carry this outside, and I'll set up the camera. Okay, I'm hoping that it works. It's plugged in and everything. I have a long extension cord. So I hope it works. Okay, I'm gonna try it without me on it first. See what happens. Yes! It works. I just have to balance my weight in the middle and it should work. Okay, I'm gonna sit in the middle. Try to. To drop in here. It's all plugged up. Give it cord so it doesn't pull on so head down. And plug one of the holes with duct tape.
So I'm gonna try going down this hill in our driveway. So it's getting a little scraped up underneath. But I think it'll work. If I'm just going to put some tape around all the edges because that's where it's getting scraped up. I'm going to try mounting a chair on it to distribute my weight a little bit. I think that will help it a lot because four legs will divide my weight into four. So it will hopefully help it so all my weight is not in the middle. I weigh about 105 to 110 pounds, so about 25 pounds, about in four different spots. So I'm going to try mounting the chair, and I think I'm going to make a part two to this because this is already like a half hour long, and it's going to take forever to upload. So thanks for watching. Go ahead and watch part two. There should be a part two, or maybe I'll just have an update video on it. So thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe and have fun building your own.